So namaste students, and welcome back once again to the JCE Connect. So I'm Naresh Patil, and today we are here to discuss the problems over calculate the flexural strength of precious concrete beam. Okay, so I'll start with the statement of the problem first. So, pre-stress concrete beam, rectangular cross section, 200 mm by 500 mm deep, is pre-stressed by tendons having an area of 600 mm square, located at 100 mm from the soffit of the beam. FCK is equal to 40 Newton per mm square, and FE is equal to, that is the characteristic strength of concrete and the characteristic tensile strength of tendons or steel is 1600 Newton per mm square. Then they asked estimate the ultimate flexural strength of the beam for the following cases as per IS code, that is IS 1343. Okay, then they have given the condition as if the beam is pre-tensioned and if the beam is post-tensioned with effective bond. There are two conditions here. For these two conditions, we have to find out the flexural strength of the section. Okay, and then according to the given data, we have the sketch here. The beam is 200 mm by 500 mm deep, and the steel is located at 100 mm from the soffit. So this is the soffit of the beam or the bottom of the beam. The steel is located, it is at 100 mm from the soffit of the beam. And other given data are, they are given the area of pre-stress as 600 mm square, FCK is equal to 40 Newton per mm square, and FY is equal to, sorry, FP is equal to 1600 Newton per mm square. Okay, so we'll go for the solution now. Okay, so that is first case one. We'll call for case one. That is, case one is pre-tensioned beam. For pre-tensioned beam, you have to find out for pre-tensioned beam. Okay, so for that you have to find out the effective reinforcement ratio first. Okay, so the effective reinforcement ratio AP into FP divided by BD into FCK, that is AP into FA on BD into FCK. So AP is given as 600, which is mentioned here. So 600, FP is 1600, then B is 200, D, that is effective depth. So effective depth, total depth is 500, total depth is 500 here you can see, and minus 100. So that is effective depth is 400 into FCK is 40. So we'll get the ratio is 0.3. We'll get the ratio is 0.3. So now from table number 11, page number 59 of IS 1343 1980. I'll forward this code book into the group. Okay, so from that you have to refer the table. So I'll show you. Okay, so when you go to the IS 1343, so you'll get this table. Okay, you'll get this table. So you can, I can show here. Condition at the ultimate limit state for rectangular beam with pre-tensioned tendons or with post-tensioned tendons having effective bond. So this table we have to refer for having effective bond. So we have calculated this ratio AP into FP divided by BD into FCK. Okay, and we have to get these values FPU by 0.87 FP and XU by D. These two values you have to find out. Okay, so for that, again it is subdivided into two columns, that is pretension, post tension, pretension, post tension. So we are calculating for pretension beam first, okay, for case 1. So we have to refer these and these for the calculation, okay. So from this, okay, so from this our value is the ratio we have got as 0.3. We have got this ratio as 0.3, you can check here, okay, we have got 0.3. then the ratio of this you have got 1, the value of this is 1 and activity is 0.655. you can see here for pretension 0.655 and for this we have got 1. So we will calculate that. So we will note down here first, okay. So therefore we got FPU divided by 0.87 FP is equal to 1. So we got from the table. So therefore FPU is equal to 0.87, FP is 1600 into 1, okay. So we got 1392 Newton per mm square. So we got FPU is 1392 Newton per mm square. Then also XU by D, so which is again from the table, we got 0.655 for steel double as for pretension, okay. So therefore XU is equal to 0.655 times D, that is 400. So we got XU is equal to 262 mm. So we got two values here. So we got two values here. One is FPU, that is 1392, and XU is 262. These two values we got. Okay. Then, therefore, the moment of resistance MR is equal to FPU into AP into T minus 0.42 XU. We have already derived this equation in lecture number 1, so you can get from that, that is FPU is 1392, AP is 600, D is 400, minus 0.42, XU is 262, okay. Then next, so therefore we got the moment of resistance is 242.17 kilo Newton meter. So this is the solution for first condition. So you got the moment of resistance, the internal resistance of the beam is 242.17 kilonewton. Means the beam can carry a moment of 242.17 kilonewton if it is a pre-tension beam. Okay. Now we'll go for second condition. Okay. Let's go for second condition. Okay, we'll go for second condition. So second condition is case 2. Okay, case 2 is for post tension. Post tension with effective bond, it is given. So again we have to refer table number 11 only, which is for effective bond. Okay, so again you have to find out the ratio AP into FP divided by B into D into FCK. So we shall get again 0.3. So from this again I will show you how to refer. Okay. Okay. Now you have to refer for this column because it is for post tension. Previously we have referred from this, Now we have to refer from this because it is a post tension with effective bond. Okay, so from this again we got this value as 0.3. So if you I'll continue, if I check, so we got this FPU divided upon duration FP, we got 0.85, and again the XU by D will get 0.558. Okay. This value and this value. So we'll note down that. So therefore we got FPU divided by 0.87 FP is equal to 0.85. So therefore FPU is equal to 0.85, FP is 1600 into 0.87. So you got this value as 1183.2 Newton per m2. Okay. Then also XU by D, you got it as 0.558. So therefore XU is equal to, we'll get 0.558 into D is 400. So we'll get 223.2 mm. So these two values we got. Okay. So again we'll go back and substitute in the formula. So therefore MR, that is moment of resistance, equal to FPU into AP into D minus 0.42 XU. Okay. So FPU is 1183.2 into 1600 into D is 400 minus 0.42, XU is 223.2. Okay, so we got 217.41 kilonewton meter. Okay, this we got. So you can check. So if it is post tension, so we got 217.41 kilonewton meter, the moment of resistance, and if it was pretension, so it was 242.17. So more or less it is equal. Okay. So this is regarding the first problem. Now I'll go to second problem. Okay. So next problem is a pretension T section having a flange width of 1200 mm and thickness of 150 mm. The width and depth of rib is 300 mm by 1500 mm respectively. The area of tensile stress is 4700 mm². Located at an effective depth of 1600 mm. If FCK is equal to 40 N/m² and characteristic tensile strength of steel is 1600 N/m². Calculate the flexural strength at limit state of collapse in flexure for T section as per IS 134 the recommendation. Okay. So according to the given data, we have the sketch here. So it is given as the size of flange is 1200 mm wide and 150 mm depth. And the rib is 300 mm wide and 1500 mm depth. Okay, regarding the flange and the rib. Then they have given the reinforcement AP. Okay, and located this, the reinforcement is located at a distance of 1600 mm from the flange. So it is 1600 up to here. Understood? So again, so we'll note down the other given data here. So AP is given as 4700 mm², FCK is 40 N/m², and FP is 1600 N/m². Okay. Now here, because it's a flange section, So in flange section, I told you there are two categories, whether the neutral axis location, whether the neutral axis lies within the flange or lies outside the flange. So that we have to check. So let us assume, so we'll assume that, let us assume, let us assume depth of neutral axis lies within the flange. Lies within the flange. Okay, so that is nothing but XU is less than, XU is less than DF. XU is less than DF. So therefore, we have again the effective reinforcement ratio. AP into FP divided by, so here it will be when we assume the flange lie, the neutral axis lies within the flange, so B will become the BF into D into FCK. Okay. That is AP is 4700 into 1600 divided by breadth of flange is given as 1200 into D. You can see here the effective depth directly they are given 1600 into FCK is 40. So this ratio will get it as 0.098. So we'll get the ratio as 0.098. Okay. So now again you have to go back to steel table. Sorry, it is not steel table, it is IS 1343. You have to go back to IS 1343, okay, to get the ratios of XU by D and FPU by FP. So you can, again we'll come back to the table here. So we have here, so this ratio we have got it as 0.098. So I think it is lying between 0.05 and 0.1. So we have to interpolate between 0.05 and 0.1. So by referring this, so we have to interpret between for FPU by this thing. So I think we have got for post tension it is 0.05, and this thing we have got, this is as pre tension beam, so that is 0.109 and 0.217, because it's a pre tension beam. Okay, so we have to check whether XU is lying within the flange or outside the flange. So for that we'll calculate the XU first. So for that, it's a pretension beam, XU by D, and for 0.05 and for 0.1 you have to interpolate and check. Okay, so we'll calculate that. So here you have got from table, you have got a so for 0 point this ratio we got 0.05, for this we have got the value as 0.109, and for 0.1 we have got it as 0.217. so we have to interpret for 0.098. so we have to find out what is the value for this. Okay, so after interpolation, if you check after interpolation, I think this value will get as, for this we'll get the XU by D value is equal to 0.212. So after interpolating for this, these two with respect to these two, so for this we will XU by D we call it as 0.212. So therefore XU is equal to 0.212 into D, into D is 1600, that we got 339.2 2 mm, which is more than DF. So therefore, assumption is wrong. Therefore, assumption is wrong. We have assumed that, because we had assumed that XU is within the flange, but here our assumption is wrong. So let us go for next by assuming. So now assuming neutral axis lies outside the flange. Okay. So for that, again, that is XU is more than DF. Okay. So now again, so that time you have to find out again AP. So this will be APW now, because it's outside the flange. So it will be APW into FP divided by, it will become BW T into FCK. Okay, understood. So here, to get APW, we have to find out what is APF. So because APW plus AFF equal to AP. So because we know that AP is equal to APW plus APF. Okay, APW plus APF. So we have the equation for calculate AFF. So APF is equal to 0.45 FCK to BF minus BW into DF by FP. So this equation we have. So we'll calculate, that is 0.45 FCK is 40 into 1200 minus 300 into 150 divided by FP is again 1600. Okay, so from this we will get value as 1518.75 mm square. We will get AP as, okay, so therefore AP is equal to, or APW is equal to AP minus APF. AP minus APF. So AP is 4700 minus AFF is 1518.75. Okay, so we will get this APW as 3181.25 mm square. This will be 3181.25 mm square APW. Okay. So you can easily find out the ratio now. APW by this ratio you have to find out now. Therefore, APW is 3181.25 into FP is 1600 divided by BW is 300 into D is 1600 into FCK is 40. So we'll get 0.265. Okay. So therefore, XU by D is equal to, again from table number you have to get this value, and again you interpolate, so after interpolating you will get 0.576. So therefore, XU is equal to 0.576 into 1600. So we will get this value as 921.6 mm. Okay, so therefore our assumption is correct. Okay, our assumption is correct, that is XU is more than DF. You got XU is more than DF. Okay, so next, again, we have to find out the ratio for एफ पी यू बाय 0.87 एफ पी सो फॉर दिस अगेन यू हैव टू इंटरपोलेट ओके सो फॉर अगेन आफ्टर इंटरपोलेशन सो एफ पी यू अपॉन 0.67 एफ पी अगेन फ्रॉम द टेबल विल गेट वैल्यू एज 1 सो देयरफॉर एफ पी यू इज इक्वल टू 1 इंटू 0.87 इंटू एफ पी एज 1600 सो विल गेट दिस वैल्यू एज 1392 न्यूटन पर स्क्वायर अंडरस्टूड सो देयरफॉर एम आर इज गिवन एज एफ पी यू इंटू ए पी डब्ल्यू इंटू डी माइनस 0.42 एक्स यू प्लस एफ पी इंटू ए पी एफ टू डी माइनस डी एफ बाय टू सो विल सब्स्टिट्यूट हियर सो एफ पी वी हैव गॉट इट 1392 इंटू ए पी डब्ल्यू अगेन इट इज 3181.25 टू डी इज 1600 माइनस 0.42 एक्स वी इज 921.6 प्लस एफ पी 1600 इंटू ए पी एफ ऑर्डर एज 1518.75 इंटू डी माइनस डी एफ बाई टू इंटू डी माइनस डी एफ बाई टू सो टी इज 1600 डी एफ इज 150/2 ओके सो दिस इज द अल्टीमेट स्ट्रेंथ 9076.95 किलो न्यूटन मीटर सो दिस इज द फाइनल वैल्यू फॉर मूवमेंट ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस ओके थैंक यू